Here are 9 of the biggest engineering disasters. Number 9. Sampoong Department Store, Seoul, South Korea. On June 29, 1995, in the space of 20 seconds, the Sampoong Department Store in Seoul, South Korea fell to the ground, killing 502 people and injuring 937 others. Criminal negligence, blatant disregard for ethical engineering practices, and shoddy construction led to the largest peacetime disaster in South Korean history. The problems can be traced almost exclusively to the future chairman of the building, Lee Joon. Under his insistence, the building was changed from being an office building to a department store halfway through its construction. To install the escalators, several key support columns had to be eliminated. Later, Joon had a 5th floor added to the building. Despite serious warnings, Joon simply hired his own company to do work others refused to do. Not only was the building meant not to support a 5th story, but its extra level was made with a thick, extra heavy heated floor. Air conditioning units that were added to the roof quadrupled the load the structure was designed to sustain. To make matters worse, the building was constructed with substandard concrete and had only half the 16 steel reinforcing bars it needed. Also, the concrete columns were thinner than necessary and were reduced even more when fire shields were installed around the escalators. In April 1995, extensive cracks were spotted, yet nothing was done. These fractures grew exponentially on the day of the disaster, but because management didn't want to lose the day's revenue, they refused to evacuate the building. Top executives, however, left as a precaution. 7 minutes before the collapse, the building began to pop and crack, and employees sounded the alarm. But it was too late to avert disaster, and a total of 1,500 people were trapped inside. Number 8. Hotel New World, Singapore. On March 15, 1986, all 6 stories of Hotel New World collapsed in less than 60 seconds. The building housed a hotel, a bank, and a nightclub, all of which disintegrated into piles of rock and twisted metal, burying 50 people inside. It was the worst disaster Singapore had experienced since World War II, and it shocked the nation. Singapore's newly formed Civil Defense Force launched rescue and recovery efforts immediately, and they continued for 7 days. Engineers and other experts from around the world were called in to assist the delicate rescue operation. At first, they merely removed beams and other remains from the top and sides of the ruins, but not many bodies were recovered. On the second day, assisted by foreign experts who were in Singapore to build a mass transit system, rescuers began to tunnel into the rubble. Sound detection equipment was used to help locate the 17 lucky survivors. After intensive research, investigators discovered a terrible error in the original design of the building. The structural engineer had completely left out the building's dead load. In other words, the weight of the building itself during the design process. As a result, it wasn't strong enough to hold itself up. Tragically, Hotel New World was doomed from the beginning. Number 7. 3 high-rise office buildings, Rio, Brazil. On January 26, 2012, a 20-story building in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil spontaneously collapsed. The gigantic high-rise crashed into another 10-story building, as well as a third, smaller building, reducing all 3 structures to one huge pile of rubble. The impact sent an enormous wave of dust through the streets of Cinelandia Square, killing at least 17 people. If the disaster had occurred just a few hours earlier, it would have resulted in mass casualties. Fortunately, the district, home to many office buildings and Brazil's prized municipal theater, was pretty desolate due to the late hour of the collapse. Authorities suggested that illegal construction work had weakened the 20-story building and caused it to fragment, which triggered a chain reaction and brought down the 2 smaller buildings. This catastrophe has led Brazilian authorities to call for reforms for stricter building and renovation regulations. Number 6. Skyline Plaza, Virginia, USA. On March 2, 1973, tragedy struck the Skyline Plaza complex in Bailey's Crossroads, Virginia. One of the complex's towering apartment buildings collapsed, leaving a huge, eerie cloud of dust and debris where it once stood. Perhaps surprisingly, construction hadn't even been completed at the time of the disaster. The building was not due to open until August. Although there was no flaw in the design per se, the forms supporting the concrete columns on the 22nd floor were prematurely removed. The cement hadn't yet hardened completely and couldn't bear the weight of the 24th floor. The failure of these columns put an increased amount of pressure on the rest of the columns on the 23rd floor until the entire floor buckled and slammed down onto the floor below. The building had not been engineered to withstand such a huge increased load, and the tremendous weight proved catastrophic. Each floor gradually succumbed and plummeted onto the story below in a devastating ripple effect. 14 construction workers died and 34 were injured. Michael Hill, 31, ran all the way down the stairs from the 23rd floor when he saw cracks appear in the ceiling. He made it to the 4th floor when he was forced to jump out of a window. He broke both his arms, but hey, he survived. Number 5. Royal Plaza Hotel, NAKHON, RATCHASIMA, Thailand. On August 13, 1993, at around 10 a.m., the once splendid 6-story Royal Plaza Hotel in NAKHON, RATCHASIMA, Thailand came crashing down in less than 10 seconds. That's 1.6 seconds per floor. Tragically, 137 people were killed and 227 more were injured in the collapse. Rescuers dug through the rubble with jackhammers and crowbars, desperately searching for signs of life. According to rescue teams, trapped survivors had been using their cell phones to call for help. A pregnant woman was pulled from the mangled pile of steel and debris 2 days after the collapse. Unfortunately, at the time of the collapse, the hotel was being used for several meetings and seminars, including a large teacher conference and a Thai oil company meeting with more than 100 attendees. Police detained the owner of the Royal Plaza Hotel, the architect, and an engineer over allegations that 3 stories had been added to the building in 1990 without proper architectural review. Also, a huge amount of water was being stored on the roof of the hotel ahead of an expected water shortage. Number 4. Ronan Point, London, England. In East London on May 16, 1968, a single match triggered the collapse of an entire corner of a massive 22-story building. Ivy Hodge, a 56-year-old cake decorator living on the 18th floor, got up early to make herself a cup of tea. When Miss Hodge lit her stove, the spark from the match triggered a devastating gas explosion. The blast tore through the joints connecting the walls to the floor and threw her to the ground. The load-bearing walls came apart, leaving the 4 apartments above her without any kind of structural support. The 4 floors came down, tearing through the floors below like falling dominoes, until an entire corner of the building lay in ruins. The building was in fact new, its construction completed just 5 days prior to the collapse. When Ronan Point came tumbling down, 260 people were in residence. Surprisingly, only 4 were killed in the disaster, while 17 were injured. Although the building was rebuilt and the joints strengthened, public confidence in high-rise tower buildings took a huge knock. Many high-rise blocks, including Ronan Point, were eventually pulled down to make room for less intimidating low-rise housing. Ivy Hodge was treated for burns, but ultimately, she and her gas stove, which she took with her to her new address, both survived. Number 3. Deepwater Horizon Explosion. The single largest oil spill disaster in history was ushered in on April 20, 2010. The Deepwater Horizon semi-submersible mobile offshore drilling unit suffered an explosion, causing a massive oil leak into the ocean. The unit, also called a MADU, was owned and operated by Transocean and was drilling for BP in the Macondo Prospect oil field about 40 miles, 60 kilometers, southeast of the Louisiana coast. The explosion caused the deaths of 11 workers and serious injury of 17 others. The Deepwater Horizon had frequent issues with maintenance that were never taken too seriously. Internal BP documents show that BP engineers had concerns as early as 2009 that the metal casing that BP wanted to use might collapse under high pressure. According to a number of rig workers, it was understood that workers could get fired for raising safety concerns that might delay drilling. Preliminary findings from BP's internal investigation indicated several serious warning signs in the hours prior to the blowout. Equipment readings indicated gas bubbling into the well, which could signal impending trouble. The heavy drilling mud in the pipes initially held down the gas. A House Energy and Commerce Committee statement in June 2010 noted that in a number of cases leading up to the explosion, BP appears to have chosen riskier procedures to save time or money, sometimes against the advice of its staff or contractors. If you ignore enough warnings, you'll eventually pay the price, and that is exactly what happened to BP. Loss of life, loss of profit, loss of reputation, and the single biggest environmental catastrophe in recent history. That's a pretty high price to pay for greed. Number 2. Highland Towers, Selangor, Malaysia. At 1:35 p.m. on December 11, 1993, a landslide with the force of 200 jumbo jets slammed into the foundations of Block 1 of the Highland Towers apartment complex. The Highland Towers complex consisted of three 12-story residential buildings built at the base of a steep hill just outside of Malaysia's capital city, Kuala Lumpur. The retaining walls and drainage system had been poorly designed, and maintenance was pretty much non-existent. The situation grew more dangerous when another development company began construction on a ridge just above Highland Towers. The land was stripped and exposed to erosion, and some of the drainage pipes were blocked with branches. 10 days of non-stop rain put an enormous amount of pressure on the pipes. At various points on the hill, the pipes burst, and the water content of the soil rose to dangerous levels. Eventually, a landslip took down a large retaining wall. A colossal 100,000 square meters of mud slid into Block 1, carrying it forward and eventually snapping it. Three people were pulled out alive on the first day, but 12 days of frantic searching failed to unearth any more survivors. In the aftermath, 48 bodies were recovered. Block 2 and Block 3 were evacuated and stand empty to this day, like grim, overgrown tombstones. Number 1. Twin Towers, New York City, USA. Without a doubt, one of the most terrifying building disasters in recent memory is the collapse of the World Trade Center on September 11, 2001. The Twin Towers were masterfully engineered using lightweight steel and a central core and an egg crate design, creating a redundant structure. In other words, if one column or support were to fail, another would take its place. What's more, each building was made to handle 5,000 tons of lateral wind load. The weight of the jets didn't come close to overcoming the strength of these perimeter columns. The real problem proved to be the 90,000 gallons of burning jet fuel that sent plumes of black smoke trailing into the sky over New York City. The fire itself didn't melt the steel columns holding up the building, it only weakened them. And though reduced to 50% of their previous strength due to the temperature of the inferno, the columns were still capable of holding up the building. The real issue came down to the uneven temperature of the fire, which distorted the steel on one side of the skyscraper. The stress proved too much, and eventually, the floors buckled and began a domino collapse, pancaking down one on top of the other. Each tower weighed 500,000 tons, and it took just 10 seconds for these immense buildings to collapse, hitting the ground at a staggering 124 miles per hour. Despite the fact that there were no specific engineering flaws involved in the design of the Twin Towers, engineers continued to study the buildings to learn more about redundant design and progressive collapse. And most importantly, with the aim of formulating life-saving safety and evacuation procedures in the future. Here's what's next. The pilots, both of whom were known to be pretty experienced, attempted a low-altitude roll maneuver. However, the pilot and co-pilot made a deadly mistake and the plane went spiraling into the crowd. The carnage that was captured on video shows the horror as 77 people were killed and hundreds more were badly injured.